And breaking news, as more and more families are speaking out, protest intensifying now with the Tirupati encounter. What you see on your screens are visuals we are getting to you now of the MDMK chief Vaiko, who's leading the protests in Vellore. Shabir, tracking more of that story, is with us on the phone line. Shabir, you know, this clearly has gained more political colors with perhaps what we've seen on the ground now, with these strong voices coming out saying that we must arrest the Andhra police now.
Well, clearly here the protests are raging in Tamil Nadu, where political parties have taken up this issue on a daily basis. There are protests that are happening in Tamil Nadu demanding a strict and a thorough probe into the Andhra Pradesh encounter that took place. And also here, MDMK is expected any time now, and he will be leading a march towards Chittoor, where he wants to protest right in front of the Chittoor collector office. And the police have denied
the permission for Mr. Vaiko to march towards Chittoor. He will be arrested during the march, but clearly Vaiko remains defiant, and he wants to protest, and And Vaiko clearly wants to send across the message that the political parties are up in arms against the Andhra government, because they want a CBI probe and a judicial probe into the killings of 20 people belonging to Tamil Nadu who are called as alleged sand smugglers. So Vaiko is no mood to relent, and here he is going ahead with this march. The picture there, you can see party workers have gathered here in large numbers in Vellore, and Vaiko is expected any time. From here, he will be leading a march towards towards Chittoor, where he is expected to protest right in front of the Chittoor collector's office.
All right, so Shabir, they're telling us more about what we can expect as far as the controversy over the Tirupati encounter now stands to snowball. In fact, these are visuals we are getting to you now from Vellore, where we are expecting Vaiko to be there at any moment. And in fact, he will virtually be laying siege to the collectorate. Now, Shabir, but what really is the state government now planning to do? You know, because it seems that it's caught between a rock and a hard place, with perhaps all political parties now mounting equal amount of pressure.
Well, clearly the state government wants a judicial probe. Yesterday, the AIADMK chief too had released a statement
and ordered an inquiry into the killings of 20 people belonging to Tamil Nadu. So here, political parties in the state are trying to mount pressure on the Tamil Nadu government, because the PMK had already issued a statement saying that the Tamil Nadu government isn't doing enough. They are not applying pressure on the central government or on the Andhra Pradesh government to order a probe, because there have been conflicting reports as far as this particular encounter is concerned. And there are many loopholes that are being pointed out by the human rights activists. So
yes,
clearly, political parties in Tamil Nadu have taken up this issue very seriously, and now it's getting more emotional here in Tamil Nadu, where people have turned out in large numbers on the calls that were given by the political parties. And here they want a judicial probe or a CBI probe to be ordered immediately, so that the truth will come out, because the relatives have given different versions. The relatives say that the people who have been who were killed in that encounter, they were picked up by the Andhra Pradesh police while they were traveling in a bus. Seven people belonging to Tiruvannamalai, and there is an eyewitness account. And human rights activists are also planning to produce the eyewitness before the NHRC to record his statement. But the eyewitness Shekhar has gone underground. His location still remains closed. Because he is very scared, and he feels that if he is out, then probably something might happen to him. His life is also in danger. So that's the kind of fear that the eyewitness has. And the villagers there, they are in no mood to relent. They have moved the High Court asking for a re-postmortem, because the moment they received the bodies, they had some kind of suspicion saying that
yes,
the bodies had some kind of other injury marks. which are clearly unexplained. So they want a thorough re-postmortem to be done so that they will know the exact cause of the death of these people. Were tortured before being encountered, or was it a genuine encounter? So these are the questions that are being raised by the relatives, and that's the reason why political parties are mounting pressure on Tamil Nadu government as well as Andhra Pradesh government.
Clearly, Shabir, then a lot of questions still need to be answered. For the moment, many thanks, Shabir, for getting us those details from Vellore.